Hello everyone. Welcome to the 21st video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. In this video, I will teach you how to use parent and link. As the name suggests, parent and link is used to link one or more layers to the desired layer. To do this, I draw a rectangle and choose a color for it. I will also add a text. I type the name of my channel and place it on the rectangle with the selection tool. I make the text smaller. In order for the anchor point to be in the center of the text, hold the control button and click on the pan behind tool. I put the text in the center of the rectangle. Now, if I select the shape layer and change its location, you can see that the location of the text does not change. It is better to place the anchor point of the shape in the center of the rectangle. Here is the parent and link option. In front of each layer, we can choose the name of the layer we want to link. For example, I select the shape layer one layer. Also, with the whip tool and dragging on the desired layer, the link of the text layer to the shape layers is done. You can see that in front of the text layer, shape layer one is selected again, and if you select none, the layer link will be disabled. Now, by moving the shape layer, the text layer also moves with it, and in fact, the text layer repeats the movement of the shape layer. To better understand this, I will create an animation for the rectangle. After selecting the shape layer, I press the letter P to bring up the position option and create two keyframes. I place the time indicator on the initial keyframe and change the position value to move the rectangle out of the composition. I press the space button to see the animation. You can see that without creating a movement for the text layer, it moves together with the shape layer. I place the time indicator on the last keyframe, select the text layer and press S to activate the scale. I create a keyframe and move the time indicator forward a bit and make the text bigger. I move the time indicator forward again and copy and paste the first keyframe of the scale. In this way, another keyframe is created. I press the space button to see the animation. Guys, don't forget that the text layer repeats the movement of the shape layer, but the shape layer does not repeat the movement of the text layer, because we only link the text layer to the shape layer. In order to make the animation movement smoother, I choose the Easy Ease option for the keyframes. I explained this in previous tutorials. Also, using parent and link, I can link the transform options for the layers separately. So I delete these layers and create another rectangle. Select the layer and press Ctrl plus D to make a copy of this layer. I change the location of the new shape and choose a blue color for it. I open the transform section of the red rectangle and create a keyframe for the position. I put the time indicator in frame 15 and create a keyframe for rotation. I put the time indicator at 1 second and rotate it by 20 degrees. In second one, I also create a keyframe for the opacity option. I set the time indicator to 1 second and 15 frames and set the opacity value to 0. In this way, this animation is created for the red rectangle. Now I link the blue shape layer to the red shape layer. By advancing the time indicator, you can see that the blue shape follows the red shape, but the opacity of the blue shape does not change. Also, don't forget that the rotation of the shapes is created from the anchor point of the red shape, because the blue shape is linked to the red shape. Now, to make the opacity of the blue shape follow the red shape, I open the transform section of the blue shape layer. You can see that in front of each of the transform options, there is also a whip option. So I hold the left click on the whip option that is in front of the opacity and drag the mouse over the opacity of the red shape layer. In this way, the opacity of the blue shape is linked to and follows the opacity of the red shape. Also, the opacity number of the blue shape changes to red. I press space to see the animation. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I see you next time.